Okay, hello there, ladies and gentlemen. I've got an orange, I've got some grapes. It's chapter 12. It's dead space. And this might be the last video. If it's not, it'll be the penultimate one. Chapter 12, been pretty crazy so far. Got a lot of stasis. I remember the next room being quite brutal. I'd say the most annoying enemies so far in this game have been the Guardians. It's kind of like playing the game for the first time again. And the Lurkers. Those guys have been boiling my piss. But yeah, let's get it.
Security card. Now entering tether control. Cross-contamination field engaged. Warning. Main power interrupted. Tether generators are offline.
Thank you.
emergency elevator offline. Notifying maintenance. Emergency elevator offline. Notifying maintenance. Power restored to East Generator. Power restored to Tether Generators. Ready for restart. Restarting Tether. Now entering zero gravity.
Isaac, power is flowing again. Come back to the marker quickly. The excavation site's just up ahead. Make us whole. Thank you. Isaac. Get the marker to the pedestal. Hurry!
Awkward moment when the batteries run out right before the end. This is where an established professional content creator edits the video. This is where I get the charger and keep the video running.
Isaac, the Hive Mind is coming. You have to make us whole.
Well, imagine playing impossible mode, getting to the end of the game, and then that happening. And you think, I'm going to try it before they patch this game multiple times. This is about, altogether, I'd say, the sixth or seventh time the game has just shat the bed in a similar way. This is the second time it's gone to the loading screen, which never ends, right at the end of the fucking game. And now I've got to reload it. Absolutely, completely and utterly unacceptable. Like I said before, Callisto never committed this many sins. Don't get me wrong, I think that although this is a remake and it should be a prerequisite, this game is better and better made, and I do prefer the combat, which was going to be obvious anyway, but the game has got a whole host of technical issues which people don't seem to really be wanting to understand. The journalists.
Get the marker to the pedestal.
Very, very fucking frustrating. Because now, look at that. Look at that. Now I've just lost loads of stasis. Fucking hate this in games, especially these kinds of survival games where resources are important, you know, fucking it all the way in stupidity. Like, yeah, I've not lost much progress, but it's just so frustrating, isn't it? Unacceptable.
Please, Isaac, the Hive Mind is coming. You have to make us whole.
How many times has that happened on this game as well? When you accidentally melee when you mean to shoot and he goes into this retarded animation of doing both at once. It's fucking stupid, man.
Isaac. I always believed in you.
Nicole.
We're whole again. We are whole.
Restart the tether. Buy us time.
No. Me. Oh, I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about everything. I just wish I could talk to someone. It's all falling apart here. I can't believe what's happening. Strange. Such a little thing. Just had a talk. That's all this research was in the end. Not much, is it? Just how to make it listen when he begged for convergence. But I had a different prayer. It spoke. And then it listened. Make this stop, I said. Maybe it understood, but I can't return the mistake. Why can't I see you again, Isaac? I loved you.
Just like Earth goes on it.
Seismic activity increasing. Evacuate to safe location.
Shuttle. I can still make it before she leaves.
Isaac, I mean it. Oh,
Daniels!
Hive
mind!
Isaac, it's me. Oh, I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry.
Okay, there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. No after credits scene, but I do believe there is a alternate ending in New Game Plus, and obviously I will be grinding for many different achievements in New Game Plus. Let's just see how many achievements we've ended the game. 33 out of 47. Let's just see how many of them secret ones, although we've got more than half of the achievements. We've only got 480 gamer score. Got shitloads of G's on today's session. We're talking hundreds, ladies and gentlemen. So, New Game Plus, I'll be getting that. Install every weapon upgrade, getting that. Ripper, line gun, plasma cutter, stores of items, collect all the schematics. I don't understand what that one is, because don't you do that all the time? I'm perplexed by that. We'll find out. Never killed any enemies with Stomp, and didn't do it much of that. And I don't know if I want to... Shall we look at the secret ones? Yeah, fuck it, let's do it. Oh, I got so close to level 6. That'll come, that'll be easy. Pick up a marker fragment for the first time. I wonder if that's New Game Plus. Very interesting. See the alternative ending. So what will that alternative ending be exactly? I'm not sure. So it took me 17 hours to complete. That's a good 5 minutes. Oh, look at that. This fella has played it just 7 minutes less than me. Yeah. 17 hours. Most people will complete this within 10 to 12. But Jesus, the original game took me 12. There's a bit of backtracking in this game, so I can't be bothered to go fully in depth. This last video has been just over an hour long. I might have to splice this particular video, just get it to about 45 minutes. The final boss there, I was a bit frustrated with, but they just made it a little tougher, which is fair enough because the original last boss was pretty easy, all things considered, all things said and done. I think they've done a pretty damn good job with this remake. I've seen people talk about masterpiece level, and I've seen certain people shit on it. It is the modern culture, ladies and gentlemen, 2023, varying ends of the spectrum, extremes, when in reality, I wouldn't say it's in the middle, I wouldn't say it's an average game, I think it's a very, very good game. It's only time will tell whether I want to return to this the same way as I do the original, but I told myself something before this came out, and I'll tell you guys right now, that I will always want to replay this game, and nothing's going to change that. I'm actually tempted to start New Game Plus now because I don't know if I exit out what will happen. I'm a bit worried by that. Actually, if I go into load game 2206, yeah, you see there's no save here. Oh wow, the game auto saves quite a lot. But yeah, things I liked. The game obviously looks very nice. I think I'm going to write the good job as Isaac again. Although in some places you can tell that he's aged a little bit and his voice does sound a little croakier than it used to, which is a shame. I absolutely love his performance in the second game, but overall I think he did a good job. I think the voice acting was a bit cheesy, more so than the original in certain places, especially Hammond and Kendra, and also Mercer perhaps as well. A few too many cutscenes. You can't skip the cutscenes right now. I think the cutscenes are a shame. The additional like backtracking, and instead of the power node rooms having the 1, 2, 3 clearance and then the security doors, you know, with the star, the master level ones, I wouldn't mind that if you were able to set a manual waypoint on the map and then follow the beam, you know, in like the older games, because I don't think you can do it in this game, where you can use it to show you the store and all that kind of shit, and the bench, etc. You can't do it in this game. Why not? It actually made it quite frustrating to go back. But yeah, I've got a lot of experimenting to do. The weapons, I mean, the contact beam, as soon as I realised the alt fire was the old school primary fire, I was loving it. It's absolutely farcical. Impossible mode, I'll tell you now, they are going to have to stop the game just randomly crashing and go into the fucking load menu and then nothing happening, because if that happens in impossible, you've lost all your progress. It's totally unacceptable. It's totally unacceptable. I've played many of these kind of games with permadeaths and died because of stupid things that weren't my fault, and this game right now in the state it's in, it's going to happen more than all sorts of other similar types of games I've played in the past. And obviously Callisto, although I do think maybe even the devs will abandon that game, to be honest, we were so poorly received. I'm still interested in the permadeath mode. I've still got to go back to that game, actually, in New Game Plus. I could do that, actually. You know, Last of Us 2, Alan Wake 2, Resi 4 Remake coming out. I've got Proteus, I've got Somerville, I've got Hi-Fi Rush. Ladies and gentlemen, whisper it. But is modern gaming actually not as shit as I thought it was? I'm having fun at the moment. And I'm a downtrodden, cynical piece of shit. So that's pretty good. But I will still complain when it needs to be complained about. But in greater detail, in the future, sometime this year, I would hazard a guess late summer, early August, early autumn, I should say, time perhaps, I'll do my impossible difficulty walkthrough on the YouTube. Obviously, I'll do it for a first. I might stream on Twitch my first impossible mode playthrough, although I'm just terrified of losing my progress. A patch came out for the game today, and it still crashed, so it's not done jack shit. And apparently the PS5 version is slightly worse than the Series X version. So, yeah, I'm just going to start New Game Plus. I might get to the first save station. But overall, first thoughts on the game are that I like it a lot, but I still don't think I'll prefer it to the original. There's so much to discuss, you know, the Kinesis is better, but apparently there's an auto aim on the Kinesis, which fucking sucks. I don't remember him missing any or many Kinesis shots. Seraphim17 did a video where he showed that there's an auto aim on it, and that's just shit. But obviously there's a lot of settings here that I could probably tweak as well to my liking. The game's way too dark, by the way. Way too fucking dark. There are certain places where you can't see what the hell's going on. I don't like the zero G. I do like how they improve some weapons like the Ripper and the Flamethrower. Do I think the second game should be remade? No, I do not. I think they should remaster 2 and 3 instead. Give us 120 FPS on the consoles. Make the games look even better. Yes, even 3, because I don't hate it, even though it's not as good as 1 and 2. And then go from there and just see if EA will, you know, green light a fourth game, which I don't think they will. But of course, we would. The hardcore fans love it. Start off, this is my start of the fourth game. And I'm not really an expert in creating stories, ladies and gentlemen. But include Carver in the beginning and then kill him off within the first 30 minutes or so, showcasing that we don't give a shit about the third game. You know, just kill him off. And then we're on Earth because the Necros are there. And then we've got to leave Earth for some reason. Control our boy Isaac for half of the game and get Ellie back for the love of Christ for the other half, and then from there I don't know what shit's gonna pop off, but yeah, could be cool. But thanks for watching, guys. This has been fun to do. It's probably be about 30 videos all in all. Got one or two videos I need to splice up and edit, but it's been fun. Thank you to anybody who's watched, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.